In this lesson, I'll show you how to create this little line which is flying around the screen. You can use that as additional motion elements to reveal something. To start things off, let's create a circle in the middle. Again, hold Shift, hold Control, and make a kind of big circle in the middle. This time, I don't want any fill, so I select the fill options. I cancel them because I want a stroke. I'll work with the violet After Effects logo, so let me select a similar color to that, so we have a feeling for it. Okay, and this time I want the stroke to be about 2 pixels or maybe 3 pixels. I want this to be really small. What do we want to do with it? Let's go to the ellipse, maybe to the ellipse path, and work with its size. At first, at the beginning of the animation, I want the size to be much smaller. I want it to be to about this size, so 150 pixels. And after, maybe after 1 second, as this animation closes up, I want it to be really, really big. I want it to follow the animation to cover around the area I've selected for my logo animation. I think this would be okay. 600, let's be more precise, 630. And let's align this object in the middle. I see I should move this one to the side. Okay, now we have the first keyframe selected, which is the size. You see the size is growing. I also want a rotation to happen. So in the transform ellipse options, in the rotation options, let's select a keyframe, go to 1 second and make it one full rotation. You see the circle is rotating, but it's kind of boring. Nothing is happening here. I want a very similar motion to the last one, so why am I bothering and not using the same tactic of using radial wipe? Because I want to show you a few tricks and let's make them right now. I'll select Add and I'll add Trim Pads. Trim Pads is a really cool thing for shape layers because we can do the same which radial wipe does. I'll come closer, maybe you don't see it. At first, at 0, I want the start and end to be 0. Let me select a keyframe. As we progress, the start should be 100% and in the end should also follow along and be 100%. The only change I want to make here, I want this to take at least 1 second and I want the end to be moved forward. This way, the end will have to follow up. So as you see, we have a similar motion like previously. It slowly grows, it turns around because we have one full rotation on it, and now we could eventually tweak it a little. Just imagine if we copy this around, we will work with the keyframes a little bit, it will really look better. Let's preview the effect we have. Okay, this circle is really perfect, maybe here it takes too long. This is a boring motion, that's why I move this here, and I select the rotation to happen here as well, so it isn't so static. You always have to make those little tweaks because you can't anticipate what will happen. You need to see it, and right now as I see it, this is a really nice motion. It ends just about here. Okay, I'm really satisfied about this animation, and to be a bit more fancy, you can even make the rotation stronger. This will make the animation a bit quicker. Let's preview what we have. And this is what I wanted to teach you in this lesson. Now you can take this line, duplicate it, for example, 5 times, stagger it a little bit, and you have a completed animation. If you did like this video, please leave me a like or comment. I'll really appreciate this. And if you would like to learn After Effects with me, you have discounted links to my online courses down below or in the right upper corner in YouTube cards. Thank you for listening and see you in the next tutorial.